Employers are requiring workers to quarantine for 2 weeks after they're exposed and test negative before they can actually go back to work. Tonight, concerns are mounting that people are forging test results for different reasons. NBC2's Annalise Garcia tells us more.
It's all circumstantial.
We're seeing it both ways, where people are having positive results and they're changing documents to say that they're negative so they can get back to work. But we're also seeing people who have negative results saying they're positive so they don't have to work.
The most common way to alter these COVID-19 results, changing words on a PDF.
These people that are getting these fake negative results really do need this job, and they need to start right away, and they may even be sick, but they can't survive without this job.
The CDC says if you have quarantined for 14 days and are symptom-free for 3 days, you're okay to return to work, but some organizations are still requiring negative results in order for their employees to return.
From an HR perspective, what we need to ask ourselves as organizations, as managers, is what are these incentives that we're putting in place that'll kind of cause someone to want to be fraudulent about this in the first place.
Like paying for the test itself.
Probably just like drug testing, the employer would pay for that.
Management professor at FGCU, Joseph Liu, tells me because of this fraudulent act, it may get to the point that organizations will have to treat COVID-19 test results like drug test results.
Drug testing similarly has people that are trying to cheat the system, and organizations see as effective as ordering the results for that test directly from a laboratory. So that will prevent some of this fraudulent, maybe just altering PDFs.
Attorney Lance Dunford tells me forging a test result may not only cost you your job.
The issues that run up are huge issues on the civil side, the liability side of things. And then on the criminal side, you can run into some issues as well.
So you might want to think twice before you submit a fake test result in order to get back to work, get out of work, or travel to countries that are requiring a negative result in order to visit, like the Bahamas. In Lee County, Annalise Garcia, NBC2.